Welcome to the LD4 Art and Design Affinity Group. Our speakers are Samie Konet, the Dance, Audio, and Moving Image Cataloger at the New York Public Library. Konet was the 2023-2024 MoMA Linked Open Data Fellow when she was first introduced to LD4 Arts and Design Affinity Group, where she later went on to present her work modeling MoMA's traveling exhibition history and Wikidata. And we've also got Alexandra Provo, Research Curation Librarian, New York University, and Research Fellow, Semantic Lab at Pratt Institute. The mic is yours.
Awesome.
Okay. Hi, everyone.
Hey, everybody.
Thank you for joining us today. Alex and I will be offering a brief overview about the scope, history, and the mission of the Art and Design Affinity Group. So if you haven't already clicked into the agenda and our sign-in sheet, the agenda is a running Google Doc. That we use to keep notes during all of our sessions. And if you could please take a moment to share your name, affiliation, where you're joining us from, and any exhibition you've seen recently or look forward to seeing in the chat. That's how we always open our meetings to get things off the ground. So I'll give everyone a second to do that.
In the meantime, we can say, so as Christine said, I'm Alex Provo, and I'm along with one of the co-facilitators of this group, along with Carly Wildenhouse and Jessica Davis, who are also in the room. We'd love to know who you are and where you're coming from and some nice art or other exhibition that you've seen recently.
Okay, so while that happens, as a brief introduction, the LD4 Arts and Design Affinity Group aims to advance the use of linked data for art and design from a library and an archives-led perspective through information sharing, exchange, and collaboration. As an LD4 Affinity Group, we're open to all, regardless of institutional or organizational affiliation. And to that end, as an early career professional, and especially as a student, when I was introduced to this group, it was vital for me to experience a lot of our calls as it introduced me to linked data actually in practice and use. And often, while in library school, as many of us are familiar with, we're just introduced to a lot of these concepts. And so to actually see the spectrum in which it is utilized in such like inventive and new and exciting ways, I think only increases curiosity and engagement with linked data, especially involving arts and design related subjects. And within this scope, which Alex will further explain within our history, we're excited to explore unique challenges, modeling, creating, querying, and visualizing linked data related to art and design. This includes and is not only limited to domains such as visual arts, performance art, craft, architecture, graphic design, and fashion, events such as exhibitions, traveling exhibitions, performances again, and auctions, and formats such as catalogs, artist books, visual resource collections, and artist files. Many of these have been explored in depth already in some of our conversations, and there are also many subjects we have yet to talk about. So we're excited to have you all here, and hopefully, some of you will come to us later to present. I'll hand it over to Alex now.
Awesome. Thanks, Samie. And yeah, thank you everyone for sharing a bit in the chat. As I mentioned, this group is co-facilitated by a few of us. An earlier version of this group had organized calls between June of 2021 and January 2023 under the name Arlis NA Wikidata Group. So we were part of the Art Library Society of North America at that time. And in February of 2023, we joined the LD4 community as an affinity group, changing our name a bit and expanding our scope, as Sammy was just kind of outlining, and to include linked data more broadly, not just Wikidata, though we certainly do talk about that as well. Okay, I think I'm ready for the next slide. So just to give you a little taste of some of the things that we've talked about since last year's LD4 conference, I bucketed them into a few categories here. We've had a lot of great presentations from folks about different projects and platforms. So we heard about Pharos, the International Consortium of Photo Archives. We've talked about dance linked data by hearing from the Dancing Digital team. We heard from one of the investigators of IDEA, the International Digital Dura Europos Archive. So more an archaeology topic there. We heard from someone from the Georgia O'Keeffe Museum about their user-centered strategy and how they use linked data. We also heard from folks at Curationist and their use of wiki data. And I think most recently we heard from the Getty vocabularies, got a lot of great detail there about the process, but also how they're incorporating diversity and flexibility and just, yeah, different viewpoints into the vocabulary. So yeah, I would say like another kind of emerging theme is like diversity, equity, and inclusion. So that's an interest that has surfaced over the last year in this group. We also have had some modeling discussions. So Ayla call on how anonymous artists are represented in wiki data. So that was really more of a like, here are some ideas and thoughts about this, but I don't necessarily have the answers, nor am I the be all end all expert. So just to highlight that there's like different types of sessions that we have done in the past, either kind of project reports, but also more informal discussions. We had a lot of discussion over several sessions about how to model traveling exhibitions in wiki data. And we've also had a few sessions more along the line of a how-to, so sharing tools and workflows related to Python and uploading images to Wikimedia Commons and creating wiki data items in batch using quick statements. So yeah, it was exciting and fun to look at what we've talked about over the last year because it has been really a variety of topics and kind of approaches.
And so, in the spirit of collaboration and to look towards the future, we'd like to invite you all in the meeting today to consider a few questions. To begin, our first question for you all is, what are some art and design topics you're interested in using linked data to represent? And in an exciting new feature, if you join us on at Slido or by scanning the QR code, in this active poll, we'll begin to see everyone's interests, which is exciting because while we do have a long history of things that have been involved, it will be interesting to see offhand for many like new users who are joining us today, what you're interested in. So I'll give you all a moment to join. If it's working, can someone confirm? Okay, there we go.
We can see that people are typing.
Nice.
Oh, and I forgot one housekeeping note. We are recording this session as part of the conference. Typically, we do not record our calls, but we take really great notes. So just want to share that as a kind of a way this group typically works. But yeah, great. If anyone, let me put the code for Slido in there as well.
Wow, look at that. This is really cool. So what we can all see on the screen is a word cloud that's populating. And so it seems like many people are interested in exhibitions as it is loudly presented in this word cloud. Wow. Oh. I'll just give us a few more minutes, and then I believe we have three other questions for everyone. And we plan to screenshot and include the answers from today in the slide for anyone's later reference. But hopefully, these questions also inspire any of you to reach out to Carly Wildenhouse about hosting a future call if you're interested or are currently doing any work related to the topics that are appearing. Okay, I'll give this last participant 1 second. Oh, new media art. Okay, get behind that. Okay, I'm going to move on to our next question. What data models and/or platforms are you familiar with for creating and managing linked data for art and design? And again, I'll give you all a few minutes to think about this. It is not surprising that Wikidata is appearing most prominently here.
But yeah, we've definitely got some that we haven't necessarily talked about in the in our calls before. I see Alma on there.
Linked art.
I don't know if we've really talked about schema.org as much in our calls. That would be kind of interesting as well.
Yeah, or arts data. I don't think I'm familiar with that one. Okay. All right, just 1 more minute. It's cool to see someone referencing the Joan Jonas knowledge base. If I'm understanding those initials correctly, that's a really cool project. If you're unfamiliar with it, I highly recommend looking it up, especially if you are interested in modeling complex art objects like performance pieces or dance. Okay, I'm going to move on to the next question. What are some unique challenges of representing art and design topics as linked data? So, again, I'll give everyone a few minutes. Whoa. These are some excellent highlights that I think many of us can agree with.
Yes, as mentioned in the chat, thanks, Carly. A lot of people are thinking about dance. So that's definitely something that we could continue to talk about in our calls. Again, that can be either about specific projects or more of a kind of exploratory conversation.
I think also many of our calls have touched on a lot of the issues specifically related to a lack of standard vocabulary, and I think that will be an ongoing conversation as vocabulary is often unique to the subject. But I understand there's issues with that, like within Wikidata, for instance, which we've talked about a few times in our meetings.
Yeah, some other stuff I'm seeing on there. We've got, oh, that's interesting to me, attribution relationships. So how to model that very complex kind of authorship and the involvement of scholarship and opinions. I'm also seeing again like performance, time-based works, those ephemera. Undefined art movements. I don't think we've talked as much about art movements yet, but that would be really interesting. Classification. Works and instantiations. Yeah, that's reminding me of our exhibition, traveling exhibition modeling discussion. So definitely something pertinent there. Events with multiple parts, similar. Let's see. And yeah, oh, I think maybe it was on a previous slide, but unstructured museum collection data made me think back to provenance. And earlier today we heard a talk about a provenance data. So that could be a fruitful area of discussion as well. It seems like maybe a lot of us are interested. And yeah, Carly expands on movements, not just movements, but how they relate to and or differ from genre. Yeah, that would be really interesting to get into.
Okay, I'll move on to our next question. This is something we've suggested you respond via the agenda chat, or if you would like to unmute yourself, you're welcome to do so. But we'd love to know what you're working on at the moment that you'd like to connect to others about, and whether that's a specific project or even an idea that you have yet to approach, but maybe believe working with the Affinity group would be a space in which you could introduce that idea. You're welcome to do so now.
So yeah, we'll give you a few minutes to percolate on that. And thanks, Carly, for keeping an eye on the agenda. I'm looking at that as well. And yeah, feel free to add there in the chat, unmute, however you want to engage is good with us.
I can't see the chat at the moment while I'm sharing screen, but just to throw an idea out there, as someone who works currently or is focused currently on the subject of dance, there's a lot of conversations moving around thinking about how choreographic work is modeled and followed within the cataloging world. But that also falls into conversations thinking about the network of relationships we could have establishing the multiple instantiations of one choreographic work. I know Dancing Digital, I think, has contributed some work to this, and there's other, sectors of the cataloging world that are thinking about it. But with all of the interest in dance, I think it also may be something we can consider having a future call on. I don't know what anyone else is thinking about, but that's just one idea that I'll throw out there.
And I'll read a couple of the answers that we've gotten in the agenda in the chat. So we have one answer. Someone's working on data validation for Wikibase and Wikidata for GLAM. We have mention of a Wiki project, Getty Library Wikidata pilot on the Kaplan collection. Working on reconciling designer, architect, et cetera, on Wikidata and modeling public lectures hosted, recorded, and streamed by Harvard's Graduate School of Design. And the next one is the choreographic work that Sammy just mentioned. I'm watching another person chat. I'm just going to give them a beat to let them complete this thought. I see another one in the chat, working on doing modeling festivals, especially separating concepts related to an annual festival edition or one-off festival from recurring festivals. I'm aware too, there's a lot of work that is to be done in Wikidata that I know of. I'm sure other platforms as well, sort of separating out recurring events, of which there are many in the art world, including biennials and other recurring exhibitions. Another one that's come up a lot in our calls is the Pacific Standard Time Festival. It's like a series of exhibitions that takes place periodically in Los Angeles around shared themes, but across multiple different institutions. We have an example of modeling drag shows and female impersonation shows. I'm going to look back at the agenda. See, just a follow-up about dance. So we have the comment, the project team No Boundaries Archive Project and Dancing Digital are looking at current opportunities to connect with the greater dance community to understand what the needs are in regards to dancers and choreographers. We have describing political buttons via structured data on commons and Wikidata items, finding ways to encourage local, state, national historic preservation entities to share their historic resource building inventories as linked open data. There's a lot of activity, which is good. And I really love like the diversity of topics. There's so many different directions that you can pursue in regards to art and design. Let's see. So we have a comment. Would love to see how others are handling event venues in Wikidata. When I'm not speaking in a moment, I'll reply with, we did have a call. I think it was two years ago, so it wasn't included in this year's roundup, about GLAM building. So I'm going to put a link to that presentation in the chat in a moment. And I know that some colleagues of mine here at NYPL are also working on separating out event venues from like the production companies that organize events at that like particular theater. So there's a lot to do there. And let's see. So and yeah, we also have that there is a cradle form for exhibit. So I'll stop talking now. I don't know where we are at with time.
Oh, we're good. Yeah, we have a lot of time. No worries. Thank you for doing that, Carly. I'm gonna just note cradle in our list here. As mentioned earlier, we do sometimes do calls about specific tools, so that's great to hear that there's some interest there.
And I think we may be ready for our last question.
Let's give one moment. I just want to see if there's anything else in the chat that I might want to bring forward. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, I just wanted to note too, I think Christine, you'd said the describing political buttons via structured data on commons. I think we've talked about structured data on commons, but yeah, that's great to surface. I think that would be awesome to talk about as well. Sarah shares, would really love to get to know more about utilizing Schecks in Wikidata and or Wikibase. So let's add that to our list as well.
Yeah, these all sound like really great projects and ideas that everyone is working on. This is really exciting.
Ryan says, I'd be curious about looking into garden design and history topics and if anyone is modeling that realm. Okay, yeah, I also want to know about that now. That's throwing me back to like papers I wrote in undergrad. And okay, so yeah, this is awesome. Thank you so much, everybody, for sharing. So just want to reiterate, like, even if you haven't, so if you have projects going on in any of these areas, like specific projects that you're doing, we are very happy to be a venue for you to share about that and talk a little bit about your work, get some feedback if it's an in-progress project where you might want, you know, an opinion about modeling or tools or something like that. But also if it's just a topic that you're curious about, like I'll throw back to the representing anonymous artists in Wikidata. That was something like folks were curious about. So, you know, we pulled together some examples and resources and had more of an exploratory conversation. So that is something we also like to do. So even if you're not, if it's something, if it's a nascent interest, or just something you want to learn more about, you can do that in community. And thank you, Carly. Another plug to suggest a call topic. Yeah, we collect our ideas that way, or you know, we're collecting them now through this brainstorm. But yeah, please do fill out that form if other ideas come to you. Okay, I think we can now move on if you want to the next slide.
This is, I believe, our final question. What other groups project or projects should the LD4 Art and Design Affinity Group connect with? If you are a part of any working groups or something your own institution is pursuing and you think it would be great to host a call or, you know, co-host a call with us, we're totally open to that.
Yeah, with that one again, we'll ask you to either share some info in the chat or respond in the agenda. And I'll say that, yeah, we've done crossover calls with other LD4 affinity groups before, the discovery group, if I'm remembering correctly. So, yeah, we are happy to have ideas for who else we should connect with, either within LD4 or other groups that you may be involved in. Okay, yes, Carly shares our next call is a crossover with the Discovery Affinity Group. That is what was coming to mind for me. And that is on the topic of semantic search in an online collection. So, looking forward to that next month. I think one we've talked about, I believe there's a group of art historians and researchers who are exploring linked data projects and workflows. So that might be a fun group to cross over with. Okay, Christine. Okay, maybe interests overlapping with the DPLA Wikimedia Working Group. Sorry, what does SDC stand for?
Oh, structured data on commons.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, that would be great because I think, yes, as Carly says, there's so much interest in visual resources and images in our group. So that would be, yeah, a really great crossover. Yeah, we're also interested to know, like, if kind of modeling discussions are coming up in other groups you're in that pertain to art and design topics. Like, this is a great ours is a great group to connect with since we have a lot of interest and expertise in that area.
Yeah, I'll just okay, it's working. I'll just add, with regards to that sort of nascent LinkedIn and art history group, just something that I've been thinking a lot about is how a lot of people who are people in organizations who are maintain creating and maintaining linked data sort of crave getting feedback from researchers who might use linked data either as part of a discovery process or as the basis for like kind of like digital humanities type work. And so just putting it out there, that's something I've been trying to think about is like, what would it look like to have these groups talk to one another? Just because I think, for instance, I've been attending a couple of these linked data and art history calls, and I think so many of the questions that they have about like how to work with linked data, like what sources are out there, like many of us who sort of work in libraries, archives, and museums or other sort of projects that create and maintain linked data are things that we're always trying to think about and communicate. So there's a little bit of a disconnect. So I'm definitely have on my mind for some point in the next year to think about how can those two like user groups come together and be able to maybe share what each respectively thinks about.
Yeah, I'm definitely interested in that as well. I think something I've been reflecting on, which if you came to my lightning talk and could hear me, because I guess my connection is bad. Like the ways that our more institutionally produced data can support those researcher projects or is even maybe necessary for those to get off the ground. For researchers to build additional data on top of like maybe our description. So yeah, more conversations like that and kind of concrete examples of that I think are really helpful.
Yeah, I also agree. I think as well, there's many projects out there that are representing networks of information, but maybe are unaware of the nature of linked data and how much easier it could be to illustrate those relationships using a tool like Wikidata or, other recommended platforms that we saw in our earlier question. But there is definitely a lack of scholarship around it in use, so it would be nice to become more involved with groups that are interesting in applying it to see what the actual use and effects are of linked data outside of the most immediate community, which is us. Okay.
So Sarah shares that she appreciated my question at the lightning talk earlier about multilingual sources and representation of sources. Yes, thank you for surfacing that. I am, as to be expected, kind of interested in that. And I think that would be something very cool to discuss specifically in the context of art and design resources. Yeah. Sorry, I was just, my wheels were turning on that one. So let me add that to our list.
Okay. Should I move to the next slide and we can open the floor a little more? Or
We might, and then we might want to go back to some of the Slido slides to spark more.
yeah.
But let's go to the next slide.
So if you want more, if you would like more information on the LD4 Arts and Design Affinity Group, we recommend joining our Google group. This will give you access to our monthly calls and agenda. There's also a URL to suggest call topics, which in a moment we can definitely go back into our Slido polls and see if there's anything very popular, and maybe collectively some of us together will want to propose something. But if you ever have any questions, many of the co-conveners and I are all accessible via the group. And so I'll give everyone a second to jot this all down, and then I think it would be fun to go back into the polls and see what populated. Okay.
I think we've got
Let's.
about 5 minutes left, right? Am I correct there?
You
Yes.
have approximately 7 minutes if you want to go down to the wire.
Wow.
Okay.
Okay. We don't need to do that. Just curious, if anything else has come up for folks, we can take a look at our responses again to jog our memory. But those were our kind of more structured questions, but we're curious to know. If you have any other questions or any other ideas for what you'd like to see this group do in the coming year. Go back and check the agenda as well.
Yeah. And also I'll circle back and just say if there are any current MLIS students or students of other programs attending the meeting today, please do not feel intimidated about proposing a call. When I presented for the group and was still a student, it was incredibly helpful for me to receive feedback of active professionals in the field, and it was a great learning opportunity for me to have more engaged conversations about many of the questions I had on my own data modeling and the work I was doing. And this group is very much an open channel for that kind of thing. So, if anything, I would really hope you feel encouraged by today to propose a call or even just start attending meetings more actively, which happen once a month.
And speaking of that, I'm going to put the oh yes, it's just a shout out from Sarah Osborne Bender to say, Sammy, your presentation was very informative.
Oh, thank you.
Just a plug now for some upcoming calls that we have scheduled. As mentioned before, in November, we will do a crossover with the sorry, I'm trying. Okay, I was about to send that, but okay, great, awesome. Thank you, Carly. A crossover with the LD4 Discovery Affinity Group on semantic search in an online collection. And in December, we will be talking about arts data. And I think, we were hearing a bit from Dessa earlier in the chat about some of their work. So we're excited about those two, but we really do want this group to focus on things that are of interest to you all. So, again, we appreciate your suggestions for calls, call topics. And we're here for, as we've said, a variety of types of calls, from the more kind of formal presentations to informal discussions to demonstrations of tools and everything in between. And our schedule is indeed open for January and beyond. So if you've got a burning question or topic of interest, it's a great time to get that on our calendar. All right, maybe we can put
Okay.
contact info in there one more time. Is that going? And yeah, I think we can wrap up there. And we look forward to connecting with folks if you haven't joined us before. And we're looking forward to upcoming calls and a great upcoming year of gathering.
Yeah, thank you all for joining us today.
Thanks for the session. This was really excellent. I see that folks are joining us, I think, for the next talk. So thanks so much for all of this and for essentially doing your own moderation, which made my job really, really easy.